We have recently celebrated our 37th year of independence, or so we say. Unfortunately for us, that declaration made in 1979 has not done us a whole lot of good, because we have not the force of numbers or the financial resources to pave our own way forward. In fact, we are as dependent now as we were back then. The thing is, we have grown up somewhat. Whether or not we are more mature or intelligent now is debatable. But we are older as a nation, our needs are now greater, and therefore the demands that we make on our government have, since 1979, increased tremendously. Those of you with children will understand this. It is easier to satisfy the needs of a young dependent child than it is to meet the needs of a young adult who, having attained the age of majority, declares his right to make his own decisions about any and everything. Yet he remains in the home without the means to sustain himself. But back to us as a nation state, an independent nation state. We have the right to make our own law. And one would hope that all law enacted now, after so many years of independence, would be in the best interest of our nation and for the benefit of our citizens. We would hope, therefore, that any new legislation passed in our parliament would be proposed by one or more of our lawmakers for the purpose of remedying a wrong in our society, or for the gain, or to gain some economic benefit for the state. We would hope that new law is not enacted because the Queen says so, or Massa says so, or Uncle Sam says so. After all, we are an independent nation, right? It therefore causes me grave concern when I read the provisions in a proposed Act of Parliament, which I am told has been passed, yet the National Printing Corporation is unable to provide me with a copy. So maybe it is yet to be passed. I give all concerned the benefit of doubt. This new act proposes from the get-go that the enforcement of any security acquired by a corporation proposed to be set up under this legislation is not subject to the Land Registration Act, Chapter 501, an act that all of St. Lucia has relied on since 1984, nor the Civil Code, Chapter 401, which has been the basis of our law way long before independence, or any other law or enactment in St. Lucia. This legislation also specifically exempts the corporation to be set up from the provisions of the Banking Act and the Stamp Duty Act. What madness is this? We keep all the law, the old law, and pass new law that is to negate the old law, which is still law in force? Huh? And we do not inform the citizens of the serious consequences of this new law? People, the essence of this act is this. You who have been unable or unwilling to meet your obligations under the hypothecs which you gave to financial institutions as security for the mortgage loans on your homes or your businesses, you can no longer rely on the provisions of the Civil Code and the Land Registration Act, which so far has allowed you to keep title to these properties and to continue to occupy them. With the coming into force of this Eastern Caribbean Asset Management Corporation Act, financial institutions in St. Lucia will be able to sell their assets, that is, your hypothec, otherwise known as your mortgage, to this asset management corporation. The asset management corporation will then have the right to dispose of this hypothec by passing several other laws which we have so far relied on in this country, and by passing the onerous procedures which the courts are mandated by the Civil Code to follow. Be warned. For commentary, I am Lorraine Deborah Glass.